and no one's heard from her since.
Did you see her hang out with anyone at the time, anything like that?
I mean, no one has seen her since Saturday. I haven't seen anything. I mean, you've always heard noise outside, but it's just people walking by pretty much.
And she just recently graduated from Mercer?
Yeah, she and I were both JD students. We graduated back in May.
What kind of person was she? I mean, what did you see?
I mean, she's as nice as can be. I mean, very personable, very much a people person.
Do you know any enemies she might have had, somebody that might want to hurt her?
No, we don't know where she is. I mean, the only thing we can think is that maybe she went out running and someone snatched her. Because, we went over, one of her friends had a key, we went inside and tried to see if there was anything amiss, but, I mean, she had a door jammed that was sitting right by it, so there was no sign that anyone broke in. I mean, the door was locked when everyone got here. I mean, we just don't know where she is.
What about in the parking lot area? I know they've been doing a lot of, I think that's where they have recovered the body or whatever they recovered from there.
Body?
Had you seen anything there? I mean, we don't know if this is the same person. You know what I mean? Like, they took out a body there earlier. We don't know if it's the same person or not. So that's how we're trying to ask people if they know who lived there. Are you okay, sir?
I think I need to sit down.
Okay. You've been studying for the bar?
No one had seen her since Saturday because we all just, there's not a whole lot of interaction unless we're doing classes.
Right.
And she was doing the online version of it.
You all studied together though?
We were in, there's two different people, there's two companies that provide it. Captain provides it and Barbie provides it. I signed up with Barbary and I've been doing the lectures that they have in the mornings. She was doing the Kaplan online, so I hardly ever saw her. I mean, I would see her go out running, but
what time would she go out running?
I don't even know when.
Was it at night or morning?
I saw her midday a couple weeks ago. That was the last time I saw her, was coming back from the bar prep on the main campus. Because we got moved over there for a week or two.
But she normally would run.
She ran all the time. I mean, she had a group that she would go running with. I don't know anyone that would want to hurt her. She was as nice a person as there is.
Was she moving soon? Did you know anything about her?
Yeah, she was going to be moving out today. She was supposed to move out today because someone else was going to be moving into her apartment, a new law student.
Do you know if she was signing? Where is she from? Is she from Maryland?
Yeah, she's from up in Maryland.
Can I just put this on you so we can hear you? Is that all right?
Okay.
I'm so sorry. Yeah, and you can just hold on for that. Thank you.
Yeah, she's from Maryland.
Yeah, I mean, she was from up in Maryland. I mean, all her family was there, as far as I know. I mean, she...
What's going on in your mind right now? Like, what are you thinking?
Why would anyone do this?
She didn't hear anything.
No.
She didn't see anybody.
Yeah, I just heard something. Maybe I could have helped.
Okay, don't worry. Do you want to sit down for a second? Get something to drink?
Do you know if a bunch of her friends are getting together or anything?
That's how I found out that she was missing. A bunch of her friends came over yesterday night, around midnight, and they hadn't seen her since Saturday, so they were trying to find out where she was.
So they were knocking on neighbors' doors and stuff?
They went in, they had a key to her apartment, and they checked around, didn't see anything out of place. I mean, it was locked when everyone got there.
That was midnight.
Yeah, around midnight, and then we went over to law school to see if maybe she was over in the library studying or something. And we looked up in the study rooms on the third floor, and there was no one there. And we came back, we looked around, and just trying to find anything to figure out where she was.
She doesn't have any family in Georgia?
I don't know. As far as I know, all of her family is from in Maryland.
Have you met her family before?
There was one time that I met them. They came down first year. She had a little dog, a little brown dog, that she would exercise out in front of the law school, and it got hit as she was coming across the road. I heard the car hit it and ran out, and she was there crying, and thankfully there was someone who came along who knew a vet or something, and they helped that, and her family came down, I think a couple weeks after that or something, and I met them just briefly.
Right.
But
boyfriend or
anything? We've been trying to figure out, she has a boyfriend up in Atlanta, but someone called him, and he hadn't heard from her. No one could figure out where she was.
So was the last person they left, or you said that somebody had seen her on Saturday?
Yeah, she went over to a couple friends' house, Garen Mueller and Joe Cairns. They live over on Walnut, and they said that she was over there in the morning, and then that was the last time that anyone we've been able to find out from had seen her.
She hadn't mentioned what she was going to do that day or anything?
Joe, he got onto her computer last night to see if she had said anything. She'd sent an email out to some people that afternoon talking about like going out to eat or something. And the last thing that there was an email that she sent out after 10 that night where she sent to, I think it was someone in Atlanta, a friend of hers in Atlanta, and she said that she was afraid in her apartment, that she thought someone had tried to break in on Thursday night, and she was afraid to stay in there, but...
Where did you hear that from? From Joe?
No, he pulled it up and we read it off the screen.
She had said that to a friend in Atlanta?
Yeah, I can't remember his name, but...
And you hadn't heard anything on Thursday night?
No.
She never came to you to tell you anything?
No, if she had, I could have done something. I could have lent her a handgun. I've got a little handgun that I have for defense. And... Yeah, something. Yeah, if she was afraid in her apartment, then, get her out of there.
Is that hard to break in on Thursday?
That's what she said in the email. She thought that someone had tried to break into her apartment. She said, Macon hoodlums tried to break into my apartment on Thursday night.
Is that her car parked there? The Chevy?
No.
Small car?
No, I think that's the detective's car, Detective Patterson.
So her car's not even there?
No, it was here earlier, and they towed it. I mean, it'd been there for days, and then they towed it to, I guess, look through, see if there was... Yeah.
How did you find out that something was wrong with the police here? Was it, when you walked up a little while ago,
The police were called last night, and they came, and they looked around, and they didn't see anything. I mean, they went in, we looked around the place... no sign of a struggle, no sign that anyone had broken in, just nothing. Just she was gone. I mean, all of her stuff was there, her ID was there, her wallet was there, but she was just gone. No, I was here this morning. I couldn't hardly sleep. I was up until early hours, and then I got home and I just collapsed. And then this morning they knocked on my door. They were looking around trying to find anything. And a few of the other friends, Burpee and Garen and Ashley, they were here. They were here last night and they'd come back this morning. And I just went out and talked with them, and then they moved us all over to the side and they bussed us all down to the department and kept us there until I got back just a little while ago. And they took statements trying to find out if anyone had seen anything, if anyone had heard anything, when the last time anyone saw it was.
Now, they haven't confirmed, at least not with us, that it was Lauren that they found. Are you holding out any hope right now?
I hope, but if they found it on the property somewhere,
talking to us earlier?
No. As far as any of us knew, they were still trying to just find her. I mean, we got an email this morning from some people that live on the other side of Kroger, on the other side of the river, that they had seen her in the past running in that area. We thought maybe someone had snatched her over there, or maybe she got hurt or something.
Okay.